Hi guys, it's Chris from Recombu, and we're here with the new Moto G4, and we're just going to do a quick comparison with last year's Moto G, the Moto G3, to see whether it's worth an upgrade. So, as you'll see, there's an immediate difference between the two phones in that the new Moto G4 is a 5.5-inch phone compared to last year's 5-inch Moto G3. They've also boosted the screen resolution to 1080p compared with last year's 720p. Now, from a quick glance, there's not an immediate difference at all. It's still nice and crisp. It's, you know, it's not many more pixels per inch packed in there. And certainly in terms of colours and the rest of it as well, there's no real difference. You still get a nice punchy screen. As you can see, viewing angles are nice and wide, so you'll have no problem seeing that. So unless size really does matter for you, there's no real incentive there to upgrade. The 5-inch Moto G3 is still perfectly fine for viewing your photos, watching movies, browsing the web and all the rest of it. In terms of the actual design, we do prefer the look and feel of the new Moto G4. As you can see, it's a nice slender device compared with last year's rather chunky Moto G3. It feels nice in the hand. It feels more like one of the Moto X devices, one of Motorola's more flagship phones. So as you can see, nice, sort of fairly slender bezels at the side down the screen, so it doesn't feel too fat, even though it is a 5.5-incher, although you probably will want to use it two-handed, because as you can see, it's a bit of a stretch to get up to the notifications bar, whereas on the Moto G3, it's generally a lot easier to use one-handed. Now, in terms of the actual interface and everything, they're both running Android Marshmallow. The Moto G3, of course, has been updated via an over-the-air update, whereas the Moto G4 comes packing it. As you can see, the Android experience is pretty much the same. You get exactly the same features, the Moto G Assistant and all the rest of it. So in terms of the actual interface, the operating system, there's not really anything in it. The new Moto G4 does run the new Snapdragon 617 processor, so it's nice and nippy, but last year's Moto G3 with the Snapdragon 410 still runs quite nippily as well. This is the 2GB of memory model, so we've had absolutely no problems with this. We have heard that the 1GB model does have a bit of slowdown here and there, but hopefully it should still, you know, it still sees the distance, and hopefully in another year or so it should still be running perfectly fine. And the Moto G4 should certainly be absolutely fine with that Snapdragon 617 as well. Should play the latest games no problem. 16GB of storage in this one. There's only this is a 16GB model as well, but it also comes in 8GB. There's only the one storage option with the new Moto G4. Both phones also have snap-off back covers, so as you can see, you can snap off the back cover of the G4, and in there you've got your SIM card slot and your micro SD memory card slot. And if we prise off the back of the G3, find a little tag, there it is, you see exactly the same. Neither has a removable battery, but they both have the micro SD memory card slot and the SIM card slot. And of course you can replace the covers with a more colourful option. And both phones also are supported by Motorola's online Moto Maker service, so you can design your own, you can pick which colours you want, what colour combinations and the rest. So you can basically have whatever kind of design you like. In terms of the camera tech, they're both 13-megapixel cameras, so let's just jump into the camera app. As you can see, not a massive amount of difference there either. We need to drag the interface out on the G3 and the G4. You just get this handy little bar right here. So you've got the flash, the HDR mode and all that. On the Moto G3, you can choose whether to have the touch focus and everything, and that's already there on the G4. So you can play around with the brightness and the rest. Exactly the same again on the G4, zoom in of course. And shots take pretty much instantly, so there's not a lot of difference in that. There we go. And as you can see, shots take pretty much instantly on both phones, so there's no real difference in terms of the speed of the shutter. Of course, we'll be doing a full camera comparison when we get the G4 sample in full. And then on the front, you also get a 5-megapixel camera on both handsets as well. So the Moto G3 is available for about £150 through Motorola's online website right now. The G4 is going to be available for £169 come early June. So if you can't hang on for the new one, then the old one is available. But of course, both will be available through the Moto Maker service. And you can also buy the G4 via Amazon and a few other retailers such as Dixon's Carphone. So that's the G3 versus the G4 in a nutshell. If you've got any questions or comments, just let us know below. Thanks, guys.